Autoclave maintenance is important, and there are a lot of intricate steps involved to ensure your autoclave's longevity. Here at Sterilizer Autoclave Solutions, we understand that better than anyone. So we'll show you how we perform one of the maintenance steps for the Statim G4 5000. Specifically, we'll go over how we maintain the Statim G4 5000 cassette. And we have Ian here to walk you through it.
So we're going to remove this cassette. I am placing it on top of the unit. However, I have a stat mat, so I'm not going to scratch the paint. I'm going to separate the top from the bottom, setting the bottom off to the side. Using a small flathead screwdriver, I'm going to put it on the back side of the seal and gently work it out. You try not to stab the seal as you're getting it out. Once it pops out, you can roll the rest of that seal all the way out. This is a new seal, so I will be reinstalling this one. However, we do want to inspect our cassette, make sure there's no rust or debris anywhere inside this cassette. If there is, you can use Scotch-Brite, Barkeeper's Friend, anything non-abrasive to help clean up that rust. Just make sure you rinse it out. Once we know that's good, I'm going to take some of the provided lubricant that comes with the new seal, and I'm going to pour about half this vial into the middle of this cassette. Next, I'm going to take the cassette seal, put a couple fingers in the lubricant, and just well lubricate this seal all the way around. We want to find the holes on the back and the nubs on the top. We're going to take those nubs, match it up with the back of our cassette, and just gently place your seal in there like so. We're going to start in one of the corners just by pressing in and up and try to line up your nubs in the corners. We're going to do that to all four corners. Once all four corners are done, and the nubs are in the corners, take it on the short side, and we're just going to press that in. Go to the other short side, just kind of press into place. When you get to the long side, we're going to split the difference right in the middle, kind of press that in and work our way out. You will get bubbles. That is okay. It will slide into place. Once that is all the way in, we're going to re-lubricate one of our fingers, and I'm going to put it right between the grooves of that seal. I'm pressing in and up. I'm going to run my finger all the way around the seal, and you will feel it set into place. We want to inspect and make sure, as we see, our seal is off by a little bit. Those square blocks should be directly in the center. So I'm going to slide this over. I'm sliding this over by putting my finger back in that groove, pressing in and pushing in the direction that I want it to go. That looks pretty good. We want to inspect the corners and make sure that our nubs are in the corners. If you do need to adjust, you can once again put your finger in the groove and slide. That looks pretty good. All right, I'm going to wipe out this cassette. This will leave residual water on your lid. You can use Stat Dry to cut down on that oil. Next thing we're going to do is put our top and our base back together. Give it a good squish test. You want to squeeze it, make sure that you have air coming out the back.
If you have any questions about the Statim G4 5000 or anything else, please give us a call at 704-966-1650, option 3 for our free tech support line. Please don't forget to like and subscribe.